It's Polyfest like it's never done before. Due to the current COVID outbreak, Polyfest will run differently this year. The show will go on, but there won't be any crowds.
It'll be different. It'll be something new, not just for us teachers, but also for the students as well, because often when we're doing performances, we feed off the energy that we get from the crowd, you know, and it just gives you a real sense of encouragement. They won't necessarily get that this year, obviously, because they're only performing to the judges.
Last year, Polyfest was able to take place as normal after being cancelled the year before. But organisers made the decision early this year to run a no-crowds festival.
People ask us, why are you still running this event with no crowd? And we're saying because it's the cultural well-being of our kids. Auckland got hit hard last year with our kids being interrupted with their schooling, and we're usually the first thing off the mark in the calendar year. So we just wanted to try and bring some normality back, and even if it means going live stream, we will.
For Manurewa High School's Tongan group, preparing for Polyfest hasn't been easy under the strict COVID guidelines.
It's been a real roller coaster trying to figure out how we're going to teach a dance to different people at different sets of time, because no one's ever been together at any one time, because a lot of us teachers were in isolation for 2 weeks. During my time in isolation, I had to do a couple of videos of certain actions for the students, so did some of the other teachers. And basically all we did was upload them online. We encouraged them to jump online, look at each video, try and learn the actions and the words, so that when they did come in, they sort of weren't too far behind.
In prepping for the festival, organisers have taken extra precautions and advice from Auckland Health providers to ensure the safety of everyone involved on the day.
I can guarantee you, I'd probably say ASB Polyfest is the safest place to be. We've been very, very strict with all the guidelines that we got from Ministry of Health and also from Auckland Council. No one's going to be lingering around, so there's sanitizer everywhere. We'll also be doing the deep cleaning of the stages and the podiums before they get onto the stage as well.
But despite all the safety measures taken, families are still hesitant to allow their children to participate.
My parents are definitely worried. They still currently are. They didn't want to let me participate, but because it is my last year, they decided to let me do it anyway. Dad's always on board with anything. But my mum was a little bit hesitant, but, you know, with a lot of convincing, I got her to let me perform just for my last year.
Although families and supporters can't physically attend Polyfest to cheer on their children, organisers have created a way where words of encouragement can reach the kids just before they go on stage.
Right now on our website, www.aspolyfest.co.nz, there's this new banner, little umbrella that we've got in there, which is do your shout outs to the kids. So we've got screens that will be at each of the stages. As they come off the bus, they'll be able to see the shout outs from family and friends from home. We have around 66 groups that are looking to take to the stage next week, and we can't wait to see you. We're going to celebrate you, and for those who couldn't make it to the stage, we look forward to seeing you next year.